So now I have come to the middle section of the mixer, and I'm going to talk about the effect section running through here and over there. The red knobs and the top set of the knobs says effects post, and the bottom says aux pre. And what that means is typically on a professional console, you would send a signal to a time-based processor through aux, and that's what this bottom knob is. And you can even see this in the master section. There is an aux input, and you would usually patch in a dynamic processor, and there is one aux send and two aux return, meaning you can send in mono and then you can return it back in stereo. So you can have a stereo reverb or delay or whatever effect you want. So what the pre and post means is that that is just when the effect is going to be applied to the signal. So post means it is going to be applied after the knob or the fader. So if this knob with the volume is all the way down, then there is going to be no effect sent to that because there is no signal to be processed. Now, if you want pre, this would affect your signal before the faders. So if I were here and I was listening to my mix, not sending anything out to the master, if I am listening to my mix through headphones and I had this all the way off, I'll be able to monitor my effects using this aux pre. If I were to turn this up and then master up right here, I would be able to hear the effects because it's pre-fader. Well, this instance is pre-knob, but typically it is called pre-fader on a console. So being that I don't have an external effect I can patch out too, I'm just going to use the effects post when I show you the actual signal flow later in the video. But that's pretty much essentially the gist of what aux sends, effects sends are used to do, especially on a basic level console like this one. Alright, so here we are on the very last section of the mixer, where I will talk about the to and fro of the sound of the mixer. As I just explained, here are the aux and effects returns right here. Right above that is a knob. It's difficult to read, but all the words around this knob are different effects. And that could be the type of reverb, a chorus reverb, basically different types of effects that can be sent using this knob. So now you can see the entire mixer and console, and then out to different places, which is the main reason why you have a console. I'm going to start with this mic channel on line 1. So I have the mic ready here, and we will start with this knob, right gain, here. And first, I'll put up the master to about unity gain, which is right about there. And then I'm going to put the gain up on the other channel. I'm going to test the mic. So when I tap it, you can see that there's a signal on this meter. And now we have the line in, which is a little bit easier because of the consistent level. And I have an audio playing right now here. So that is inserted into stereo channel 5 and 6. And so if I start, bring that up, you start to see some signal going to our master channel. That's how it is done. Now, because I have a couple of mics here and I want to avoid feedback as much as possible, I don't have any outputs sent to the monitors or to the main. But I can show you, once I have these channels up in the proper gain structure set, and then all you need to do is simply to turn the volume up for the main and turn up the volumes for the monitor, and your audio will go out like so. But that's pretty much how you gain the audio in and out of your console. It's as easy as that.